press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hearty welcome to you, dear students who have joined this institution, Siddhaganga PU College. Siddhaganga Education Trust, Davanagere. It was founded in the year 1970 by Sri M.S.S. Shivana, who is fondly called M.S.S. The school which was started then, now it has grown to PU level. PU education is given to the students in addition to school education. PU College is now running under the able leadership of Madam Justine D'Souza and our director, Dr. Jayant sir. The institution is one of the best PU colleges in Karnataka state. This college is meeting the new challenges in imparting education to PU students. The institution has got well-furnished classrooms with standard furniture, standard desks, green board, so on and so forth. Each room is capable to accommodate some 70 to 80 students. Normally, 70 students will be allowed to sit in a classroom. Sometimes it is less than 70, 65. The college has got very good laboratory facilities. Laboratory facilities are up to the expectation of PU board. As per the directions and expectations of the PU board, laboratory arrangements are made in this institution. In addition to classrooms and laboratory facilities, there is excellent teaching staff. The teaching staff includes both experienced lecturers and professors and youngsters also. Whether they are experienced lecturers or youngsters, everybody is suitably qualified and competent in teaching. Every member of the teaching staff is struggling hard in order to update their knowledge with regard to the teaching and their teaching subject. They are moving from perfection to perfection. They are actually proving their mettle in meeting the expectation of the students in the classroom itself. In addition to excellent teaching that is given in the classroom, ready material is provided to the students. In all the optional subjects such as physics, chemistry, mathematics, biology, computer science, and also in English language side. See, these ready materials have been prepared by the expert staff in our college. Considering the questions that may appear in the board examination, and competitive examinations such as NEET, JEE, etc. In addition to that, periodical tests and examinations are conducted right from first PUC, beginning of the teaching in the first PUC itself. Yes, we are living in the competitive world. Just teaching the prescribed syllabus is not our motto. In this modern competitive examinations and modern world, our students should be well equipped to face both the board examination and the other competitive examinations, which will pave the way for the students to enter some professional courses. Yes, every week there will be tests, and here and there examinations for full paper will be conducted. After completing each and every chapter, tests will be conducted. While conducting the tests, care will be taken to see that all possible questions will appear there. If the students concentrate on those question papers from the beginning till end, that would suffice to meet the challenges in the examinations. All questions will be there, nothing extra will be there. It is impossible, of course, because in our text itself, question papers will be there. All sorts of questions which may appear in the examinations, both board examination and competitive examinations, will be there. Then, hostel facilities are there for the students coming from different districts of the state. Yes, our institution is capable to attract the students from all over the state. That itself is a proof to say that the institution is a standard one. Hostel for boys and hostel for girls are there. And rooms are well equipped, of course, for the hostelites. Suitable cots and study tables, etc., will be provided to the students. Moreover, hostelites will be having another benefit. After the day's teaching, in the evening, study hours will be conducted under the supervision of our own teaching staff. The students will be asked to sit in the classrooms and study there itself. And if they find doubts, if they get doubts with regard to any topic they are studying, they may ask the lecturers that are there, who are there, and they will get their doubts clarified. Moreover, of course, our senior lecturers will be there during the time of test. Even then, the students may contact those lecturers and get their doubts clarified. Study our facility will definitely help the students to face the tests and examinations effectively. They can have suitable discussions. They can get their doubts clarified. They can go to the tests and examinations with full of confidence. Day scholar students or day school students are also there in our institution. These day scholar scholars or day school students, in order to come and return to their homes, come to the college and return to their homes, bus facility is there in our college. Buses will run to all corners of this Davanagere city. The students could avail that facility to come to the college and go back to their houses safely. In addition to that, there is another facility for these day scholars. If they are willing to attend the study hours in the college itself, those students will also be allowed to sit in the classroom and study the things. Benefit will be there. It depends upon the liking of the students. Management. It's a wonderful management. It considers service to the student community is the uppermost thing. Management considers the development of body and mind among in the students. It gives importance both to the curricular activities and co-curricular activities. The very purpose of giving equal importance to curricular and co-curricular activities is to see that there is a proper development of mind and body. If importance is not given to one of the two, it will be a lopsided development. Therefore, institution thinks, management thinks, sound mind and sound body are important. Importance should be given to curricular and co-curricular activities so that we can produce healthy individuals to serve the society in future. Students from all over the state are joining this institution. It is not a surprise because students know very well what sort of education is being given in our institutions. It is capable to meet the aspirations of the students and also of the parents. Parents bring their children and get them admitted in our institutions because they have the guarantee that the right kind of education will be given to the children in this institution. Management thinks that it's a joy to send the students to face the different course, different examinations effectively. After the board examination, the students will also be prepared to face the competitive examinations like CET, NEET, JEE, and other examinations. It's a joy to the institution that the students of this institution are coming out of those examinations in flying colors. And they are going to pursue their education in different fields. Medical field, dental field, engineering, BSc Agri, BBSc, B-Pharma, D-Pharma courses, and even some other courses. It's a wonderful thing. Secondly, our management thinks giving education to the students in this institution is a service to the society. Thirdly, the institution thinks giving good education to the students is nothing but creating a very good generation of youngsters to serve the nation in future. Yes, our institution is doing a very wonderful service to the students joining this institution. Of course, immediately it may not be possible for the institution to start the classes. We are waiting, the institution is waiting for the government order, of course. But students need not be worried about it. Even the classes are not yet started, the students could avail the facility of online teaching. Preparation is all already going on. Online classes will be started to the benefit of those students. The students are here advised to listen to the lectures in online classes. While classes are going on, it is the duty of the students to hold their notebooks and pens. Better to note down the important points and listen to the lecture again and again, so that they will be able to understand the subject, able to digest the subject, able to face the examinations effectively. So here it is the appeal of the management to the parents of the children to join their hands with the management and with the teaching staff, only to encourage their children to study the things very seriously, study the lessons very seriously, whatever that is taught through online classes, and when classes commence, whatever the teaching that will happen in the classroom, they have to study very seriously. If they do it properly, it will be a wonderful achievement while facing the examinations. So, the institution once again appeals to the parents to encourage their children to follow the instructions of the management as well as the teaching staff. That will certainly help them to achieve wonderful things in their examinations. Having this much of talk with regard to the institution, as a lecturer in English, I would like to speak to the students about the importance of English, about the way of studying things in the classrooms, etc. I am K.S. Veerbhadraya, a lecturer in English. See, you students, after the completion of your school education, you are coming to pre-university education. It is a transition from school level to the college level, that is pre-university college. And here you may find certain difficulties in understanding lessons properly in the beginning itself. Most of the students are coming from rural area. Most of the students have been exposed only through Kannada, the way of teaching in Kannada, see, medium of instruction in Kannada. And some students may have been exposed to this English right from the beginning itself. And I feel that students coming from rural area may not be having good English, but they are also brilliant. Their brilliance we can see in the marks they have already scored in the 10th standard examination. They can learn this English. They can learn all the other subjects through English easily, suppose they give proper concentration. Yes, what about learning this English is concerned? Think about the learning of your mother tongue or regional language. Mother tongue or regional language, in the beginning a child learns it through listening and speaking process. Listens to the parents and listens to the brothers, sisters and other relatives there. It goes on forming words and sentences in its mind. It begins to imitate the parents and others in the society about their way of talking. And within 2 or 3 years, it learns that mother tongue. The other two skills of the language are reading and writing. Reading and writing, they happen in the classroom itself. That is how the child learns its mother tongue or regional language. By the time the child joins the school, it will be having a wonderful knowledge of the mother tongue. It is capable to express its feelings through that mother tongue or regional language. And here it is Kannada. But what happens with regard to English? As soon as the child goes to school where English is, teaching is started in English, first of all, the child will be asked to write the letters, read the words, etc. So reading and writing will be given primary importance, listening and speaking will be given to secondary importance. That is the problem here. See, the secondary importance is given to listening and speaking. Suppose listening and speaking is given primary importance at the school level itself with regard to English, automatically the children will learn the language in a better way. Unfortunately, it is not happening in most of the schools. So children just read and write that English, then slowly begin to understand different words and their meanings. That problem is there. How to frame the sentences? The children will be searching for suitable words. It is the problem here with regard to the students who are coming from rural side to colleges. Then, what should the students do to gain good command over English? It is possible, of course. Take my own example. Up to 10th standard, I studied everything in Kannada. Only at the PU level and college level, I started to listen to everything through English. Now I am teaching English, of course. As a boy, I studied everything through Kannada. Then after graduation, I just began to teach English. So English, you try to consider, it is another language just like our mother tongue. Suppose you go on using this language, it will be easy for you to learn the language effectively. That means I don't like to say neglect mother tongue. Give equal importance to mother tongue also. Read good books in Kannada. Acquire knowledge. Read good books in English also to acquire knowledge. Suppose I listen to any educated person from North Karnataka. Chandrasekhar Kambar Gnanapeetha Awardee. When he speaks, I begin to, I desire to learn to speak Kannada in that way. Anybody from Mysore side, any professor from Mysore side speaks in Kannada, I develop the desire to speak like that. Though there are dialectical differences, both types of Kannada appeal to my mind, appeal to my heart. That is the beauty of that Kannada. Therefore, acquire good knowledge in Kannada. Try to express your feelings in a beautiful way in Kannada. But at the same time, for our practical purpose, learn English. Then, how to learn this English? Yes, keep it a habit of reading books. What sort of books? See, primarily your textbooks will be there in physics, chemistry, biology, mathematics, etc. Your English textbook will be there. Study them seriously. You may find new words, of course. Try to get the meaning of those words. If possible, at the advice of your own lecturers, buy some English books and read those books. In the beginning, short stories, and later novels, etc. There you find wonderful vocabulary. When you are growing in getting good vocabulary, it will be possible for you to understand this language and express your feelings in English. That is there, of course. In addition to that, listen to me this statement by Francis Bacon, a famous English essayist. Reading maketh a full man, conference a ready man, and writing an exact man. Reading maketh a full man. Yes, go on reading books. See, in my opinion, it is better you science students get some biographies of great scientists. And you can read, when you read those good books, you will learn the life story of that scientist. You will learn about the achievements of that scientist. You will learn about the different aspects of the life of that scientist. Will it not be an additional knowledge to you? The achievements certainly will inspire you to do something special in the field of science. You will be inspired, you will be motivated. Suppose you read the books of great writers, autobiographies or biographies of great scientists, great reformers, great historians, so on and so forth. Yes, that is there. Therefore, Francis Bacon says, reading maketh a full man. When you read such books, there will be accumulation of knowledge in your mind. They will make you a full man with full knowledge. Conference a ready man. Suppose you sit for a discussion with your friends and learned people. The discussion that happens there, that will make you a ready man. That means you can express your feelings readily because of the knowledge you gain in conferences. Writing an exact man. Suppose you keep on writing whatever knowledge you have gained. That will be a permanent impression in your mind. So to have that permanent impression in your mind about the things what you read, definitely that will be there permanently. You can just share that knowledge with others. You can educate others also. Yes. Why not read the newspapers at least half an hour or 1 hour a day? Suppose you keep reading newspapers, especially English newspapers. I advise you science students, because you are going to study everything in English. While you are reading that English newspaper, you will understand what is happening in different parts of, important events happening in different parts of the world. Moreover, there are supplementaries. Supplementaries appear in the appear once in a week or twice in a week in that newspaper. Those supplementaries carry different types of articles. Articles may be related to social system, may be related to science, may be related to sports, may be movie matter, may be some achievements of some great writers, book reviews, etc. Then, there are some important articles in the editorial column and also in that editorial page. Some great thinkers like economists, political thinkers, some ex-ambassadors, some other learned people, they contribute their articles to some famous newspapers. Read such special articles. See, don't think it is a waste of time. Suppose you read an article, you will understand the deep knowledge of the writer there. Many of the things will settle in your mind. You can talk authoritatively before others. Suppose your mind is full with knowledge. Therefore, reading books, yes, you get knowledge. Reading newspapers, you get knowledge. Suppose you discuss the matter with others, you get knowledge. Suppose you write the things what you read, that will be a permanent thing, of course. Then another interesting thing, dear students. Yes, in the classroom, yes, most of you are coming from rural background. Yes, Oppolana. Yes, I agree with that. You listen to the lecturing of the lecturers. They will explain the things in English. In order to acquire knowledge, suppose you get doubts, why not ask questions to the teachers? Asking questions to the lecturers is the right of the students. It is not to test the lecturer, but to acquire knowledge. See, once Mahatma Gandhiji has said, the real student will ask questions to the teacher only to gain knowledge, but not to question the knowledge of the teacher. If he asks questions to the teacher to test his knowledge of the teacher, it is arrogance, he has said. Therefore, dear students, try to ask questions to the teachers with an intention to gain more knowledge. Wherever you get doubts, you have the right to ask questions. You do that job without any hesitation. Teachers will be there. With all pleasure, they will try their best to clear your doubts. Even if they fail to answer, they will definitely get the answers and they will explain the things in the next class to meet your needs, meet your knowledge. Then, what should be the attitude of the students in the classroom? When the lecturers are explaining the things in the classroom, don't sit idle. Have the textbook, if not textbook, at least you must be having the notebook and pad. When the lecturers are explaining the things, note down the important points. As much as possible. Those points will certainly help you after the classes. You can go through the points. You can understand what the lecturers explained in the classroom. Suppose you get doubts even after the classes. You can have a friendly discussion with your friends. Then try to use English. In the beginning, it may look awkward to you. But don't hesitate to speak in English in order to understand the subject. Why I advise you to speak only in English? Because you are supposed to answer the questions in the examinations in English, not in Kannada. If you cultivate the habit of using English in your casual conversation with your friends related to the subjects, automatically you will improve your skills in framing sentences, in asking questions, etc. That will be an additional knowledge to you, dear students. So, whatever important things you listen to in the classroom, note down the important points. Then have discussion with your friends only in English. That will certainly help you, of course. Moreover, tests and examinations will be conducted periodically. Every week, tests will be there. And once in a month or once in 2 months, examinations will be there. Examinations for full paper, 100 marks. Tests will be for 50 marks. Tests will be both for board examination and NEET and JEE. Yes, you go to the test with full preparation. You answer all the questions. You come out of the classroom after the test or examination. You feel that you have not answered certain questions properly. So just note down those questions where you have not answered properly. Leave the questions that you have answered perfectly. That day itself, study the material, study the test. Material will be there, textbooks will be there. Study them seriously and prepare the answers to the questions which you have not answered sufficiently in the examination or test. That is how you must make your preparation. If you get all answers for all the questions there, that is your 100% preparation for the questions. Do the same thing in each and every test and examination. After getting the marks, after knowing the marks of the test, see where you failed to score good marks. Just clarify them with your lecturers. And it is your duty once again to go through the test and answer the questions properly. Suppose you answer those questions once or twice very seriously at home or in your rooms, definitely that is 100% preparation, perfect preparation. If you do that, there will be permanent knowledge about those things in your mind. See, preserve all the question papers of the test and examination separately. Question papers of physics on one side, next chemistry, next biology, mathematics or computer science or Kannada and English. Yes, have all the 6 sets of question papers separately. See, the question papers are there. You have answered all the questions effectively. So full knowledge is already with you. And whenever you just glance the question paper, answers will be clear in your mind. That is the way of getting perfection with regard to your studies. Yes, in addition to that one, try to have proper rest also. Try to enjoy good food that is provided in the hospital. Medical attention will be given by our own doctor, Dr. Jain sir. So, proper environment is here, a conducive atmosphere for your studies. You can enjoy good food, you can enjoy good learning, and you have to concentrate in your mind to learn the things perfectly. Suppose you do these things, there will be nothing at all at the time of the examination to study. Just glancing the question papers and recalling the things what you answered there, what you learnt in the classroom, that recalling is very important. If you are capable to recall the things that you have learned, that is perfect learning. So that is enough for the time being. And in the classroom, you will get something in detail with regard to different subjects. Consider each subject is important. Just don't give importance only to the optional subjects. Give importance to languages also. Languages are very necessary. How to react in the society. If you do not learn how to behave in the society, if you do not learn how to use the language, whether it is Kannada or English properly, you will be a misfit in the society. See, many students score very good marks. I have seen them. Yes, 100 marks in each subject, 200 marks in two or three subjects, and 99 in other subjects. They may not score well in languages, but at least they must have good knowledge of English and Kannada to behave with the fellow human beings in the society. And that is culture. That culture will be yours. Suppose you study the lessons in Kannada and English effectively. Lessons in English and Kannada are prescribed only to mould your character. Suppose you gain knowledge in all the subjects, and suppose you do not mould your character, what is the use of that? So character is also important. If character is lost, everything is lost. A famous saying is there. Therefore, give importance to have sound mind and sound body. Let there be good character which will just inspire others to follow you. Let that be your character. Yes, with this introductory talk, I welcome you students to our college, where you will find, here you will find very conducive atmosphere to develop your knowledge. Thank you all.